I'm Alex Villarreal with the VOA's Special English Agriculture Report. In September, world leaders met in New York City to discuss progress on the Millennium Development Goals they set 10 years ago. 5 years remain to meet 8 goals to reduce hunger, poverty, and disease, and expand education. United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon opened a 3-day summit meeting of 140 presidents and prime ministers. Mr. Ban called for renewed efforts to meet the goals, saying there is much more to do. He said the economic crisis cannot be an excuse for limiting development efforts. President Obama spoke September 22nd, a day before world leaders opened this year's debate at the United Nations General Assembly. A UN report says the world had more than 1 billion undernourished people last year. That followed the food crisis of 2007 and 2008. This year, improved economic conditions are expected to reduce the number of hungry people for the first time in 15 years. The number is predicted to drop by almost 100 million to 925 million. Jacques Diouf, head of the UN Food and Agriculture Organization, says that is still unacceptably high. He says the expected decrease in world hunger is mainly the result of better access to food as the global economy recovers and food prices remain below their highest level of 2008. But wheat prices rose after Russia halted grain exports in August because of a severe drought. That ban is now extended until next year's harvest. In Mozambique, 13 people died in recent riots over higher prices for bread, electricity, and water. The cost of bread rose by 30% after the government ended price supports. After the protests, the government said it would halt the price increases. Officials from FAO member countries met in Rome to discuss current supply and demand for grains and rice. A top FAO official recently said on the agency's website that a new food crisis appears unlikely. Hafez Ghanim said there is no cause to worry unless there is another shock to supply. He gave examples like more bad weather or government policies that shake the market. The UN says 2/3 of the world's undernourished people live in 7 countries. These are India, China, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Pakistan, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Ethiopia. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal.